important to play roles in a rational society. And the question is, what does it mean rational? Rational comes from ratio. Ratio means to measure. So in our societies, we measure everything. So we want to measure also love. Why we think it's love? Sometimes you say, okay, now I'm not going to love too much. Maybe I will suffer if I love too much. So I don't open too much myself. Okay, so the point is making everything, you know, measuring everything. We made a measurable society. And measurable is very close to miserable. Measurable, miserable. So when we start to understand those qualities, that we have it, all these qualities is in our inner self. You know? Clarity, transparency, warmth, luminosity, art, love, brightness. We understand the meaning of light. Not anymore like, you know, in electricity, you know, positive, negative, you know, together brings that effect. We understand it's much more than that. We understand that light is vibration. We understand that light, it is consciousness. So we start to see that it's completely different when we see everything only with the physical eye, when we start to see with the eye of the soul. So we start to see everything is alive because we see that we have light, because we see we have that light, because we see that light is love. So we can see that everything, everybody, we are the same. So when we start to experience, have the feelings, have the process, it's really when we understand, you know, this oneness, we understand the meaning to be children of the sun, the children of the mother earth. As you notice, from Peru, many teachers come with much wisdom from their ancestors. Of course, great ceremonies with the Mother Earth, with the offerings, with the mesas, it's perfect. But it seems that we are forgetting this other aspect, the connections with the Father Son. The practices that our ancestors used to do to expand that light in our hearts. Because we have to remember the name Inca. What's the meaning of Inca? So you want to tell somebody maybe? Inca comes from two other words. From Indi, In. Okay? From the Father's Son, there is a ray of light that comes and touches us. Because we are a great expression of the Mother Earth, no? In the physical body, we come in this reality as a priest, like a crystal. So the light of the Father Son touched this priest. That ray is Kana. Kana is also clear. That's the first valley. Because that light is clear. That light is transparent. The one that comes from the Father's Son. Kana touches. And we let flow the luminosity of the seven rays. Okay? So that's Inca. Okay? That's why in the colonial period, when the chronicles they've been writing, they will not say like Huamanco Mareyala, it doesn't say Inca, it says Inga. Inga, because he could not write Inca. So the original name, the etymology of the word Inca comes from there. And also in the late Titicaca area, we have a nation, the Aymara nation, The name of this culture was Lupaca. Lupi is the sun, Haka is the people. So we are talking about the children of the sun, or the luminous people. Lupi, sun, Haka. Also we have then another community called the Pacaje, Paca, Haka. Okay? So, the first practice to remember on that. It's not to remember all the words. No, it is about to feel the light. How we remember? With the Father's Son. But even sometimes it's, we can't see the Father's Son because the building is many, many good pieces. But it's just visualizing in our hearts that light. Okay. When we awake, start to awake immediately to the heart to see the light. As much we see that light, we start to see that what we are. But we start to see and to feel it. We start to see the others. Never again. You know, we have that tendency to see the others when we see inside. And usually, some things we like the most. But what about if we start to practice deeper to see the light inside of us? And we start to see it in the others. But it's not only about the others. It is really about all expressions of life. This kind of practices, it really puts out the new way, the new attitude. So, to connect with the Father Son, you know, one day I was just opening myself to the Father Son. One of the elders told me, "So you are greeting yourself?" I said, "Oh no." And I was thinking, "Oh, I never greet myself." And then I start to understand that I was greeting the Father's Son in my mind, but I was letting the Father's Son touch my inner son. Then I was letting the Father's Son greet into me. But then, who was doing that? It was myself. I was greeting that ray of the sun that I had. So all of us, we are. So this is a great way to greet ourselves. So what about if we greet ourselves outside? Do you want to do the practice outside? Okay? Now? It's okay?
Yeah.
Okay, very good. Let's go. A couple minutes.
Vamos.